Welcome to Make It Simple channel. In previous videos on compound interest, we have seen how to solve basic problem using shortcut formula. In this video on compound interest, we are going to see the problem related with simple interest and compound interest. Okay, in this video also we are going to solve the problem using only shortcut. Now we will see the first question. In this question, simple interest on a certain sum of money for 3 years at 8% per annum is half the compound interest on rupees 4000 for 2 years at 10% per annum. The sum placed on simple interest is, so in this question, what they have given? They have given simple interest. They have given simple interest is nothing but half of compound interest. Okay. So first we will find compound interest. In compound interest, the sum is given as 4000. So rate of interest is 10%. So 10% of 4000 is 400. So since they have given 2 years, so we have to take 2 times. So 10%. What we will get? 40. Okay, so compound interest formula for 2 years you will be knowing, that is 2a plus b. So this 400 is a and this 40 is b. So when we substitute here, 2 into 400 plus 40. Okay, so compound interest, what you will get? 840. Okay, fine. So simple interest is nothing but half of compound interest. So half of 840 is 420. Okay, simple interest, you all know that the interest remains the same for every year. So here 8% per annum, and here what they have given? 3%, 3 years. So 3 into 8% what you will get? 24%. Okay, this is simple interest. So in simple interest, since interest remains the same, so you will multiply with year. Okay, so this 24% is nothing but so we have to find 100%, that is principal. So 420 by 24 into 100. Then we cancel it. 6 4s are 24. Here 7 6 are 42. 0. This 4 and 100, when we cancel, we will get 25. So what we will get? The principal amount 0. 7 5s are 35. 3. And 1750, and equal amount of sum is invested in M and N. Both the scheme offers compound interest at the rate of 12% and 9%. If at the end of 2 years the total amount received from both the schemes together was ₹1,77,000, what is the amount invested in M? So in this question, they have given two schemes, that is M and N, two schemes they have given. So equal amount is invested in both the schemes, but here the rate of interest is 12% and 9%, and here remains the same. So since this principal amount they have not given, so we will assume it as 10,000. So in M scheme, they have invested for 12%. So when we take 12%, we will get 12,000. Since it is for 2 years, again we will take 12%, we will get 1440. Okay, this 12,000 is A and 1440 is B. So compound interest for 2 years formula is 2A plus B. When we substitute it here, we will get 2 into 12,000 plus 1440. Okay, we will get, what you will get? 25,440. Okay, this is interest for interest from scheme M. Okay, now we will find interest, compound interest from scheme N. So same, that since the equal amount is invested in both the scheme, we are taking 10,000, and this rate of interest is 9%. So we will, what you will get? 9,000. So since it is for 2 years, we will again take 9%. you will get 810. Okay, so compound interest for 2 years formula is this 9000 is A and this 810 is B. So formula you will be knowing, that is 2 into A, that is 9000 plus 810. So you will get 18,810. So since we are assuming the principal is 10,000 in both the scheme M and N, the compound interest what you have got is also in units. So actual amount they have given in the question, that is 1,77,000. So you will substitute it here. That is, when we add this 25,440 plus 18,810, we will get 44,250. Okay, this 44,250 is nothing but $1,77,000. So this zero and this zero will get cancelled. When we cancel these two, we will get 4. Okay, since one unit is 4, the question what they are asking, what is the amount invested in M? So amount invested in M is 10,000. Okay, one unit is 4, so 10,000 unit is 40,000. Okay, option D. Next question. A simple interest on certain principal for a time period of 4 years at 8% per annum is 1280. If the same principal is invested at 10% per annum compound interest, what will be the amount after 2 years? Okay. Here, in this question, the compound interest principal is not given. It is for 4 years and 8%. Since in simple interest, the rate of interest remains the same. It is 8% for 4 years. So 32%. So in simple interest, rate of interest remains same for the 4 years. So we are taking 8% into 4. So this 32% is nothing but 1280. Okay, so what you have to find 100%, that is principal. So 1280 divided by 32 into 100. When we cancel it, what you will get? 8 fours are 32, 1 8s are 8, 6 fours are 48, then 0. So this 4 and 16. So 40, so principal amount is 4,000. Okay, it is the principal amount for simple interest. So in the question they have given, the same principal amount is invested in compound interest. Okay, so this 4,000, what they have taken, the rate of interest is 10%. So 10% is 400. So again 10%, so 40, so this 400 is A and 40 is B. So compound interest for 2 years is 2A plus B. So 2 into 400 plus 40. So what you will get, compound interest is 840. The question what they have asked, what is the amount after 2 years? So amount they are asking. So amount is principal plus compound interest. So 4,000 plus 840. Okay, we will get 4,840. Next problem we will see. In this question, Suresh invested rupees 25,000 in scheme A at 20% compound interest and 20,000 in scheme B at 25% compound interest for T years each. At the end of T total interest received from scheme A is 11,000, then find the interest received from scheme B at the end of T years. In this question, they have invested amount 25,000 in scheme A and 20,000 in scheme B, both in compound interest, and rate of interest is 20% and 25%. And here the T years, the total years, they have not given. And so we have, so in this question, we will assume this the number of years they have invested as 2 years. So we will, let us take this as 2 years. Okay. In scheme A, rate of interest is 20%. So 20% can be written as 1/5. So principal, then amount. So principal is 5 and amount is 6. So this one, this 5 is how we are writing. We have explained in last video on compound interest. So in description box, we have given the link for that video. Just go and check it. This is for 2 years. So we have to take again this 5 and 6. What we will get here? 25 and 36. Okay, principal they have given, that is 25,000. So this 25 is nothing but 25,000. So 1 unit is 1,000. Okay, what do you want? We want question they have given at the end of T total years, interest received from scheme A they have given. Scheme A they have given us 11,000. So this component is nothing but difference of this 36 and 25. What we will get? We are getting 11 units. So 1 unit is 1,000. So 11 unit will be 11,000. Since we got this 11,000, this 11,000 they have given in question. So we have assumed the T years as 2 years. That is correct. Okay, we have assumed it correctly, so that only we got this compound interest from scheme A is 11,000. Okay, now what you have to find? Interest received from scheme B. Okay, the scheme B rate of interest is 25%. This 25% can be written as 1/4 principal and amount. Okay, 4, 5. Then again 4, 5. What you will get? 16 and 25. Okay, now the 16 unit here, sum they have given is 20,000. So 16 unit is nothing but 20,000. So 1 unit will be the 16, this one 4 times and this one 5 times, that is 5,000. So again when we cancel it, what you will get? 1, 2, then 5 and 0. Okay, so 1 unit is 1,250. So what they have asked? Interest. Interest is nothing but difference of this 25 and 16, that is 9 units. So 9 units will be, you will get 1,250. This is the 9 units is 11,250. So this is the interest received from the scheme B. Okay. On seeing this question, on seeing compound interest question itself, you will feel that it will take some time and you won't attend an exam. Now in this question, they have given two compound interest and two different sums and two different principal and two different rate of interest. But this question, using this shortcut, you can solve it very quickly. Okay, you just apply it in the exam. Now we'll see the next question. The sum of money becomes 4,500 after 2 years and 6,750 after 4 years compounded annually. Find the sum. So this principal amount they have not given. Then after 2 years it becomes 4,500. And after 4 years, from the principal amount, after 4 years it becomes 6,750. Okay. Since this 4,500, it took 2 years to become from principal amount to 4,500. So this 4 years minus 2 years will be 2 years. So here we will get 2 years. Okay. Since the time duration is same from T to 4,500 and 4,500 to 6,750, the ratio of this amount will be same. Okay. 6,750 by 4,500, this ratio is equal to this 4500 by t, since the time duration is same. So this ratio remains the same only when the time duration is same. When the time duration is different, we can't make this ratio as same. Okay, when we cancel it, what we will get, this 0 and 0, then 1 5s are 5, 3 5s are 15, and 5 5s are 25. Here 90, when we get cancelled, we will get 10 and 1, 1 9s are 9, and here 15, then 3, and here 2. This 3 and this 4500, what we will get, 1500. So principal amount we will get it as 3000. Okay, next question you will see. Rupees 2400 becomes 3000 in 3 years at a certain rate of compound interest. What will be the sum after 6 years? So the same method you will apply here, but here they have given the principal amount. Principal amount is 2400, and in 3 years what it will become? It will become 3000. Then after 6 years they are asking, from the principal amount they are asking 6 years. Here it took 3 years to become 3000, so 6 minus 3 is 3 years. Okay, this amount we don't know, we will take it as x. Since the time duration is same, we will take the ratio. Ratio is 2400 by 3000 is equal to 3000 by x. Okay, this 0 and this 0 will get cancelled, and 4 times and 5 times, and this 4 and 3000, 7 4s are 28, 5 4s are 20, 0. So what you will get? 0, 5, so 3750. Okay. Next question we will see. What sum of money at compound interest will amount to 480 at the end of first year and rupees 576 at the end of second year? So principal amount they have not given, and after 1 year it amounts to 480. Then after 1 year again it amounts to 576. Okay, since the time duration is same, the ratio we can equate it. So what we will get, 576 by 480 equal to 480 by t. So when we cancel it, this one and this one, 8 table, this 72 here we will get, here 60, then this 72 and 60, 60 table 10, here 12, this 12 and 480 here 4 times 40. So principal amount we are getting as 400. Okay, option C. I think you like this shortcut of compound interest. If you have any doubt regarding this compound interest shortcut, you just post it in the comment section. For more queries and doubts, mail us to makeitsimple.0105@gmail.com. If you like this video, subscribe to our channel. Bye-bye.